Can you tell us a bit about who you are, where you are from, and about the work you make?
Yeah, I'm Will. I'm from Peterborough, and I'm a portrait painter, heavily inspired by Dutch Golden Age portrait painters like Rembrandt.
What informs your practice? Are there any specific things that manifest in your work, like recurrent themes?
I'd probably say it's all about relationships, and I think portraiture as a whole is about the relationship between the sitter and the painter. So my work's kind of about, on a personal level, the relationship between me and the person that I'm painting, but also about the relationship between material and flesh, and the kind of material, what that symbolises in the work.
Interesting. So, do you paint from life, or do you paint from photographs that you take?
In the beginning I take a lot of photographs, and I work from them, and I use them to sketch out the composition, but as the painting develops I move on to working from life and also using my imagination.
So I've noticed a slight change in your work. So you're working with close-ups. So you've been cropping the images. What is the significance of that?
The significance of that is because I think in my work before it was very obviously inspired by Golden Dutch Age portrait painters, and it wasn't necessarily contemporary enough, and too much of a copy, I think. And I think it's important to be of your time, and so I've been keeping the influence and the techniques of previous painters, but being influenced by modern day photography.
Interesting. What role does symbolism play in your work?
I think what the material symbolises, for example, a veil, that has relevance to the work, but it's more of a tool to blur the face and create a more interesting painting, because the subject is more ambiguous.
It's like a different texture from the skin. So how does your knowledge of the traditional painting translate into your practice as a contemporary artist?
I think that, in my opinion, there's no better painters than painters like Rembrandt, and I think even though they're from 500, 400 years ago, you're still learning from them today, and I think their paintings are timeless, and that's something I want to achieve as an artist, so it's important to draw influence from them.
Is it about the use of light, the composition that influences you?
Yeah, I'd say everything. I just think, like, the way that the paint is handled, colour, light, just everything, I think.
How has your practice changed since you started uni?
I think just being more ambitious with scale, and also, like, that includes increasing scale, but also painting on a small scale, being more daring with the mediums I use and the different effects that they can create. Because I think before I used to paint very photorealistically, but now I've kind of moved on from that and been more adventurous with mixing other mediums into the paint.
You use oil paints?
Yeah, oil paint.
And you mix them with liquid?
Liquid, linseed oil, turpentine.
Have there been any significant turning points in your practice?
I'd say when I started to use glazing and the different effects that they can give, and I think that's where my painting really started to improve, especially with colour, instead of like the painting being really dull, getting more variation with colour.
Would you say that you have a distinct colour palette that you always use, like your go-to colours?
I'd say orange, like a stained orange, which I like to keep showing through. I use them pretty much all my paintings. I think, and then on top of that, I usually use cool colours on top to contrast against that.
Where does the stained orange come from? Why is that something you keep using?
I had a painting in second year that I did, and I just stained it orange for some reason, and then I painted on top, and I just liked the effect that it had with the school cool skin tones against the orange.
Can you tell us a bit about the process, the painting process, what it looks like? You start with underpainting?
Yeah, I always start with orange,
orange,
and I stain the canvas that way, then I use thin down burnt sienna to sketch in the composition, and then I either do a black and white underpainting or I just do a really thin coloured underpainting, and then on top of that I just slowly add thicker paint until I eventually on the last layer mix in chalk to create like an impasto effect, and then sometimes on darks I then glaze to create them, like give more depth to it.
What do you want the viewer to take away from your work?
I think I'm a technical painter, so I want the viewer to appreciate the work and have like a strong focus on the way that the paint's been handled. But also if they could maybe get some sort of emotion from it, even if it's just like appreciating the work that went into it, yeah, that's what I'd want. I want them to be impressed.
By the skills and the detail. And you can ask if you keep a sketchbook, if you write down ideas, if you...
No, I just have a book. Or I have, like, just some sketchbooks of various places I've been, like that one's from New York that I saw painting from. And I just, like, sketch stuff like that, like paintings I see that I like.
And you sketch these from life?
Yeah, from life in the gallery. And then I just like put little notes about what it is I like about the painting and stuff.
So visiting the galleries and looking at the paintings from life is significant?
Yeah, it's really useful, we have to see. Because especially when I'm looking at technique a lot, you can't necessarily always see it on a picture.
In the photograph, because it makes it all flat.
And then I have a notebook of just research, like of painters that I like, how they paint, like some documentaries that I've watched of like how they mix paint, how they layer it.
How long does it take to finish a painting usually?
In terms of hours, I don't know, but I usually spend like the full like 6-7 weeks on the painting. And I try to get as many as I can on a go at once and swap them around. So I don't know in hours, but like a good month or a month and a half.
Cool.